Here is a look at the San Antonio Spurs lineup. Plenty of scoring here. Indeed, these are two relatively high-scoring teams, and Gervin gives you that extra punch of a guy who can always get a basket when he needs it, and Mike Mitchell is certainly an outstanding scorer. Bulls, meantime, Caldwell Jones will have a big challenge in the middle, and Dave Corzine will be teaming with him. You'll see a lot of the both of them. And so it'll be jumping center, Artis Gilmore, 7 feet two. Caldwell Jones, 7 feet, 2-inch height advantage to the Spurs as we get ready for the jump ball. And the Spurs got both games, both in San Antonio and here in Chicago a year ago. And this is meeting number 22 between these two teams. The Spurs have had a very, very good basketball team for several years. And because of that, they have dominated the series to date. So we're getting ready to play ball here. The Spurs are in the dark visiting uniforms, Bulls in their home white. Tip, they'll redo it. Looks like that was stolen just a little bit. Not thrown quite high enough. Here's the story. Both of these teams, well, you wonder why they're scoring? I'd say those numbers tell you right there. Tapped out of the circle, finally picked up by Gilmore. He could not touch it with a foot in the circle, and the Spurs will have it for the first thrust of the basket. Banks lets go a shot. Misses right off the bat. Caldwell Jones, fighting hard, was able to get the defensive board, and the Bulls strike down the court. Watley, Woolridge, he'll fire. Misses. Jordan trying to keep it alive, does so to Woolridge as he... Jordan managed to tip it away from Artis Gilmore. Here is Woolridge. He's covered by Banks. They should have a nice matchup there if they can post him a little bit. Jordan will take the shot over Moore. Nope. Fight for the board. Caldwell Jones with a hook. And the Bulls are on the board.
Well, we saw the forwards do most of the shooting, and then Michael Jordan came up with a little 15-foot pop, missed it, and a nice rebound by Caldwell.
San Antonio on the forecourt. Mitchell posted up, missed on the shot. It's tipped out. The Bulls have it. Jones tipped it out to Jordan. Down the lane, all the way. Basket, he put it in.
Well, he's got him standing in the aisles already. There he comes now. Billy Betts, and he turns it on, and he becomes Captain Marvel. Slides down the lane, around, banks it in, and draws the foul. Captain Marvel.
Gervin gets the foul, it's his first, and Jordan will try for the three-point play. It's there, and the Bulls with a 5-0 lead right out of the gate. They've gotten on top in this game, and the Spurs still looking for their first 2 points. We're a minute old here from the stadium. Moore deals off, Banks swinging through with a kind of an off-balance hook shot, and Jordan bringing it down the floor, driving, passes behind his back. Woolridge was not anticipating it. And he bounced the ball off of Gervin's foot, and the Bulls have it out of bounds.
Good play, heads-up play. That time Michael wanted to create something down the middle, and he just laid the ball off to Orlando, and a little hassle for the ball. It went out of bounds.
Coach Kevin Locker, I'm sure, had to be pleased with the kind of hustle that he saw right there. Jordan with a miss. Rebound to Banks. And the Spurs in the forecourt. Jordan is covering Johnny Moore, the point guard. Head fake Mitchell. He walked. Artis, he walked with it.
Artis a little upset. He says, hold on. Let me get down in low. Let me try something low. And, of course, he's leading the NBA in field goal percentage. That's why their percentage is so high as a team.
Yeah, because Gilmore hardly ever misses. He always gets it down in there deep where he can really overpower a lot of his opponents. Jordan, low feet. Steve Johnson hooks it up over Gilmore and puts it in.
Boy, if you remember last year, we got Steve Johnson to play against Artis that first game. Remember the great game he had last year against him?
You're right. He caused all kinds of problems for Gilmore, who had a lot of trouble handling him. Couldn't stop that hook shot. Quick hands by Watley. Almost tore the ball away. Here's the power move over the middle. Gilmore. And as he was trying to get loose in there, he drew heavy traffic and a foul. And this one goes to Bulls center Caldwell Jones. That's his first and the team's first.
Well, the Bulls were reviewing during their shoot-around the plays that would be run by the Spurs, and that was one of Artis will take that ball, go to the middle, put it down. If he loses control, he'll fake and then try to dive back in the middle. He did that time, and Caldwell Jones picked up foul number one for the Bulls.
Artis Gilmore shooting over 80% from the foul line. Missed that first one. That's the numbers on him. Boy, that's a great free throw percentage for a big guy. And, of course, he's been around this league a long time now. This is his 14th year in the NBA. Spurs are finally on the board. It took him 2 minutes and 2 seconds to put a point on the scoreboard. Bulls in the forecourt. Watley. Caldwell Jones. The hand back to Watley. Moe driving the baseline. Gervin spinning in on him. Offensive foul called on Watley, and the ball goes over. So the San Antonio Spurs get it back to move the length of the court. Moore with the inbound pass, and Watley puts pressure on. Little screen releases that pressure. Then to Banks. Bulls recover defensively. They have a double team down there. Mitchell, look out. Gervin's open. George Gervin was able to put it in while in the air, all in one fluid move. Here's a nice move. And Jordan missed on it, but it was followed in by Steve Johnson. Steve Johnson has four. The Bulls working the offensive boards. And they have a 6.9-3 lead. And timeout is going to be taken by the San Antonio Spurs. Coach Cotton, Fitzsimmons does not like what he sees. Timeout on the floor. We'll be back in Chicago in a minute. Well, the Bulls are off to another good start, and we'll remind you the broadcast rights to this game have been granted to Sports Vision by the Chicago Bulls solely for the entertainment of our viewing audience, and any reproduction or other use of this program without the express written consent of Sports Vision is strictly prohibited. Bill Hazen back with Johnny Kerr. We're floor side here, center court at Chicago Stadium, with the Bulls and the San Antonio Spurs.
One-on-one. Look at Gervin and Jordan.
Yeah, he feeds it in the medium post area. Gilmore right to the hoop. Front rim's on it, and the Bulls come out of there with it. And, boy, they have their track shoes on now. Woolridge quickly down the floor. In the middle, Watley's open. The Bulls are looking for each other, and they're finding each other. 8 points, the Bulls lead. This is their largest of the quarter. And the Bulls are on the move. Low lob for Gervin inside. Knocked away. Steve Johnson saved to the sideline. Jordan got it. And the Bulls have the ball. He flipped it while falling out of bounds. Here's a feed towards Steve Johnson. Jordan flipped it while falling out of bounds to Caldwell Jones.
Good action involved. They thought the ball was going out. Now watch the ball. Saved by Jones. And it just sort of hangs. Gervin comes after. But Jordan, watch him. Looks like he's out of bounds. He hangs in the air, throws it back in.
Bulls, after the common foul to Mike Mitchell, have it in bounds. And Watley, low feed. Steve Johnson, look out in there. Lays it up and in. Steve Johnson got loose inside, and he has a 6-point first quarter. You have a good memory, Red, the job he did last year. I had forgotten that, but you're right. He was outstanding on Gilmore a year ago. Now, if Caldwell Jones can hold Gilmore down, then the Bulls have a pretty good formula here.
They want to go one-on-one with Gervin, and Jordan just won't let him catch the ball.
Yeah, he's having all kinds of trouble. He's running the baseline. They can't get it to him. Moore with a long one. Misses, and Jordan has the board. And the Bulls are up by 10 and looking for more. Jordan all the way.
He lost it. Yeah.
Ball goes over.
I have to laugh. You know, he has that tongue hanging out the side of his mouth. You hope he doesn't get hit in the chin to bite it off. But
hope he doesn't swallow.
He said he learned that from his father. His father used to do that when he was working. And he used to hang around him as a young kid and watch him, and he just picked up that habit.
Johnny Moore in the forecourt. Watley is on him. Two very good ball handlers. Gervin low. Missed. He missed the layup. Got the rebound. Puts it up. Blocked by Steve Johnson. And the Spurs have it. Here's Moore driving. Steve Johnson, and they're going to give it to the big guy, I think.
Michael's got to come out. He took the blow. I thought, let's see, Steve Johnson takes the blow here, but Michael Jordan had got hit a little early. I think he's going to come right out. Quentin Daly in for him. They didn't blow the whistle.
I think they gave the foul to Steve Johnson.
Yes, they did.
Right.
Yes, they did.
Here's Gervin in the lane. Forces it up there. Front rim's on it. Woolridge fighting for the board. Keeps it alive, and the Bulls come out with it. Lead for Jordan behind the back. Woolridge lost it going up. At the other end, driving, flips it. Gervin's open. Man, can this team score baskets? Gervin has four, and it is a 13-5 ball game. I'll tell you, that has to put a little fear into anybody when you see guys like Banks and Gervin on the break. They're so quick and such good scorers. Here's Jones driving around Mitchell. He hit the bottom of the basket, though. Lost it.
Good move by the Bulls, and they lost control of the ball.
Gervin down the lane, goes up for it, and a high arching shot. He managed to put it in. Gervin has six. Down the other end, Woolridge. Off of the glass, drew the foul. And Gilmore will get this one. That's his first. 13 foul on San Antonio.
Two big jumpers going at it. Artis did a nice job. He blocked him, and then when he knew he was going to get the foul, he said, Orlando, you got to make this one from the line. Daly in now to replace Michael Jordan. Michael was huffing and puffing a little bit. He couldn't catch his breath.
Orridge misses the first free throw. He is still not on the board. So the Bulls with Daly and Watley in the backcourt now. Jones, Johnson, and Woolridge up front. San Antonio still with their starting five. Oh, Woolridge missed them both. How about that? And the Spurs quickly up the court. Look at him go. Banks grabbing in, and Quentin Daly just grabs and holds on for dear life. This team will fast break with anybody.
better be back. And that's the situation. Nobody was back to help out. Quinton Dennie had to reach in. That was a shot of Gene Banks, a forward going to the hoop wide open, and the guard had to reach in and take the foul.
So Gene Banks steps to the foul line. Not a particularly great free throw shooter, but just as I say that, he goes on the board with his first point of the game. Banks is a good scorer, especially inside. He had that one game against Los Angeles. I'm sure the Lakers will never forget it when he got 44 points on LA a couple of years ago. They used to use him coming off the bench a lot, but he has earned a starting spot this year. It's the Bulls by four now. Watley driving down the lane. He's open. Got the hoop. Enos Watley with a nice move. And Watley's off to a good start. It's the Bulls by six. Watley has four. Gervin trying to move. Kicks it out. Banks in the lane. To Moore. Gervin driving. Pumps it. No. Rebound. Yes.
Well, again, the moves, the same type moves. Mr. Smooth. The Iceman, George Gervin, he flipped it up off the glass. Everybody up in the air when he came down. George had it and played it back.
He has so much English on the ball, you'd swear he's a professor. Johnson low, got the basket. He goes right to the hoop and puts it in. He has eight. Bulls again by six. Cotton Fitzsimmons was not happy with the defense on that play. Feed in for Gervin, knocked out of bounds.
You see Gervin doing most of his work on layups. He hasn't hit anything outside. He goes right to the hoop. He wants to go over the top now of Quinton Dennie, and Dennie is looking for all kinds of help.
Cotton Fitzsimmons, you just saw on a moment ago before he put the camera on him, he was not pleased with the defense on the last series defensively for San Antonio. Here's Gilmore. It goes to Banks, 10 to shoot. Moore cutting under heavy pressure. Gilmore, look out in there. Lost it going up. Foul call. Not sure who hit him for the Bulls. Might possibly Steve Johnson. I think he was right in the area.
Well, they found the open man, Artis Gilmore, and Johnson came over to help out. You saw Orlando Woolridge, a forward on one side, and the other forward, Steve Johnson. Johnson picks up the ball.
Gilmore helps himself in a way that a lot of big centers don't. If you foul him, he's going to hit his shots from the foul line, at least a pretty good percentage of them. He's 2 for 3 tonight for 2 points.
Even when he's not at full strength, he scares you just by being in the lineup.
He's just so big and strong that, you know, you have to come at him. It's like, come to Papa. He's there waiting for you down at the other end. I'll tell you that. And he's an intelligent player. He reads defenses, reads things very well. Woolridge to Watley. Driving all the way in. Tried to lay it off. Woolridge did not make the cut in time. He got caught behind a defender and couldn't break.
And like to see him work a little bit to get the ball to Daly, get him a shot early.
Spurs could pull within two here if they score. Foul called on Watley on the drive. That's the second personal foul. And I have that as the 15th foul, putting the bonus light on at 5:06. Wes Matthews getting up to come in for the Bulls. And Watley comes out. So Matthews, who had been cut by the Philadelphia 76ers. We'll also see Jordan back in, and Steve Johnson comes out now. So Jordan's up front. Matthews and Dennie at the guards, Jordan, Woolridge, and Jones up front.
You don't usually see this. A guy coming off the bench averaging seven assists. Wes, yeah. Your leader is Watley. Yeah. And right behind him, only trailing by three, is Wes Matthews. Johnny Moore's had his hands full tonight. He's trying to make the plays, and he's got guys running by him and around him.
Got them both, and now it's a two-point ball game with the Bulls leading.
That's eight points from the foul line now for the Spurs. That's keeping them in the game.
Indeed, they're getting a lot from the foul line. Matthews, he'll look inside. Dennie comes around the screen. There's that shot you wanted, Red. Didn't go down for him, though, and Gervin has the outlet pass. Here is Moore. Fakes the drive. Matthews holds him off. Looking low. Mike Mitchell, double team, goes up, doesn't get it. Jones with a rebound in the Bulls. Kick it out quickly. Matthews, he has Woolridge on his left, Dennie on his right. There's Dennie, the fadeaway, no. Fight for the board, kept alive. Matthews, no, he went over the end line with it. He went over the end line with it, and the ball goes over. So the Bulls grudgingly give up possession, and the Spurs can tie it with a hoop. Moore brings it into the front court. Bulls have led from the outset. And that's despite the fact that the Bulls have doubled the turnover.
Isolation
the
here. Watch it down low.
Gervin looking to go up on Dennie. He does. And we have a tie score. 10 points for Gervin, who is off to one of those amazing first quarter starts of his at the Bulls. will take their first time out of the game. We'll pause. 4:07 left for the quarter. First quarter of play tied at 17. Bill Hazen back with Johnny Kerr here courtside, and there's the story as you see it. 17 apiece with 4:07 left in the first quarter.
And Bill would like to welcome CableNet to tonight's Sports Vision preview. To see all the action of the Hawks, Bulls, the Sting, call CableNet at 299-9170 during business hours for your free Sports Vision upgrade.
Yeah, that's a great package I hear, that Sports Vision upgrade, so investigate it. 299-9170.
CableNet.
Yeah, all in favor of that. Bulls will inbound it. We're tied at 17. Bulls going to break that tie. Here if they can score. Jordan, nice move to the baseline. Runs into heavy traffic. Dumps it off. Here's Woolridge driving. The head fake goes up. Got the basket. Oh, my goodness. He put that one in over heavy pressure from Artis Gilmore. That was hard work. Moore in the forecourt. Banks. Here's the jump shot by Mitchell. Long of the mark. He's off. He's not shooting well. Matthews, after the rebound by Woolridge, look at him go!
Boy, he and Johnny Moore going backwards, and once Wes Matthews gets you that way, he gives you a stutter step. You can't turn around. You go left, he goes right.
Yeah, he stutter steps, and then bang, he's gone. Then he's got you on your heels. Man, oh, man. Well, the Bulls, after being tied 17, they've come right back here with two quick baskets and taken a four-point lead. Here's Gilmore. Look out. He's in there deep, driving. Offensive foul. Offensive foul on Artis Gilmore, and the ball goes over at the 3:15 mark in the quarter, and the Bulls have it back with a chance to go up by six. How about that?
Good job by Caldwell Jones. He stepped back on Artis.
Looks like the Spurs are getting ready to make their first substitution of the game. Big Ozell Jones is off of the bench. He's a rookie. Woolridge driving. What a ball! Wouldn't go down as he managed to avoid a blocked shot attempt by Gilmore. Out of bounds. And here is Ozell Jones. We just told you about him. A rookie from Cal State Fullerton who's coming in. And Gilmore is coming out of the Spurs lineup.
They like this young man.
6 feet 11, 233 from Cal State Fullerton. Bulls with the inbounds pass, and boy, the Bulls held their own on the boards against this very strong and powerful team, and there's Daly knocking in his first two. Everybody who has been on the floor for the Bulls has scored, all seven players.
The stadium has picked up something here. When he gets the ball and shoots it, you can hear him holler, "Q!"
Yeah.
On the way to the hoop.
Mitchell on the baseline. He got open in there. They finally got it to him, and Mike Mitchell is his first two, and it's a four-point Bulls lead at 23-19. In the forecourt, Michael Jordan. Banks guards him from afar. Jordan right down the lane. Bails out at the last minute. Daly's open. Missed the shot. Rebound. Caldwell Jones. The fadeaway. Goal. He put it in. Caldwell Jones has 4 points. And it is the Bulls by six. Approaching the two-minute mark for the quarter. Jordan tried for the steal. Banks down the lane. Gervin almost stolen. Ball came loose. Bulls have it. Credit Quinton Daly with a nice steal in there. Jordan. Woolridge driving, goes up, foul.
Travel
with it, sure enough.
Everybody in the stadium up, the bench up, a little screaming at Blaine Reichel. Kevin thought he had two free throws coming, but no traveling music. Caldwell Jones, nice job. He leaves Dave Corzine in for him.
All right, so Big Dave comes in off of his best performance of the year against the Indiana Pacers. He's on for the first time. Moore on the drive, and it finally goes in as it rolled around up there. Johnny Moore got a nice drive to the baseline. He has a four-point first quarter. And it's a four-point Bulls lead. We're down to a minute 40 in the first quarter. And the Bulls on the attack. Matthews, Daly up top. He's open. He'll shoot that. And Quinton Daly has 4 points for the quarter, and the Bulls are now up by six once again. Boy, this has been a game played at a furious pace in the first 12 minutes here. Moore, Matthews won't give him any ground. Driving, kicks it out. Long one, Mitchell, foul, basket counts. Mitchell has four.
Well, he's as good a forward as you'll find out. You'll find in this league scoring-wise, a great touch. He played for Cleveland. He was sensational. Here's the pass off. Watch him get his feet together perfectly up over his head. Oh, catches him right on the wrist.
And Orlando Woolridge with his first personal chance for a three-point play here for Banks. And if he does indeed deliver on that, it would pull San Antonio within three. Or excuse me, Mitchell. I meant Mitchell, not Banks. Mitchell has four. He'll go for one more here. He does. He gets it. 5 points in the quarter for Mike Mitchell. One of the real premier scoring forwards in the game. Does it all. Came out of Auburn, of all places. where he holds records down there, not yet been broken. Corzine going up. Nice fadeaway jump shot. Dave Corzine is two.
Mike Mitchell's playing Corzine, and of course Corzine played with him when Corzine was in San Antonio.
So Big Dave's on the board, and it's the Bulls by five again. Moore in the forecourt. They're having to work hard to get that ball in low. Moore's open. Finally knocked it down. Moore has a six-point first quarter. Virtually all of the scoring, or a lot of it, 16 of the 26 points that the Spurs have are from their two starting guards. They have nothing off of the bench and very little from their front court. This shot, rebound, Dave Corzine has it. To Jordan, driving, no. Lost it, lead pass, Gervin, can he get there? Has Matthews to beat. Puts it in. George Gervin has a 12-point first quarter. And it's now 1 point, and the Bulls will hold for the final shot with 20 seconds left. Into the forecourt comes Quinton Daly. That's the score. 10 seconds. He's waiting. Now gets the word from Kevin, says go ahead and take it in. Daly has his pocket pick. Moore came up with the ball, tried to send it ahead, and he was fouled. Submarine. Daly had no choice but to take him down.
Well, he stepped on his heel, I think, trying to get around. Let's take a look, Bill. There's the steal. Good steal. Now watch him out in front. I think he tripped on his heel there, and down he went. I'd be surprised if they don't give him a two-shot foul on that. John Paxton in.
3 seconds left of the quarter as Paxton comes into the Spurs lineup. Graduate of Notre Dame, so for him, this is like a home game, I would imagine. Or a feeling of coming back home anyway. Johnny Moore to the foul line.
He's got a brother that's not a bad player out in Portland.
Ooh, I'll say. I'll say. Moore can tie it. He does. And the Bulls send Sidney Green in the lineup in place of Orlando Woolridge. Green is a strong rebounder.
19 points out of that guard position now. San Antonio.
They've gotten a lot of production out of it. Moore gets them both, and that backcourt is carrying them here early. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Here's Jordan. He'll fire a three-pointer. Got it! He put it in! He just beat the buzzer! Michael Jordan has a three-pointer, and the Bulls have a 32-30 lead at the end of one quarter of play here from the stadium. Wow! Well, just a few moments, you Sports Vision viewers saw a great way to end the first quarter. I'll tell you, Michael Jordan did it all.
Dave Corzine in the inbound pass, flying Michael Jordan comes down. Now watch him. He knows where the three-point area is. He pulls up, stop, lets it fly. Beautiful on a jump shot. Ball rotates beautifully. I don't know if it'll catch anything but the net. For three.
Simple enough. Nothing to it, huh?
That's how you can score in 3 seconds.
Here's what's going on in the rest of the league tonight. The Washington Bullets taking on New York, Milwaukee and Atlanta, Cleveland, Houston, Denver meeting Phoenix. That's a good battle of two mountain area teams. New Jersey and the Clippers. Portland will be hosting Dallas. Seattle hosts Golden State tonight. So there's a big full slate of games going on in the NBA, and we're starting to get a good feel for the teams that are getting out in front early.
Fred Roberts now in. Out of Brigham Young, second-year man.
Yeah, indeed. 6'11", capable of scoring inside. Pretty good player, second year. Daly on the baseline, goes up for a jump shot. Missed on the shot. The rebound comes out to the Spurs. They get tied with a basket. Ron Brewer in the lineup also for the San Antonio Spurs. Paxton in the backcourt. Pump fake. Down low, Brewer. Let's go the shot, and he knocks it down. Brewer's on the board with two.
Oh, Cotton's got a fine shooting team. He brings this group in here. They hustle. They're big.
Boy, and they look hungry, too, this year.
Watch Ozell Jones. He's a leaper. He tries to protect any mistakes he might make, but these are the kids that hustle it for you.
Jordan with a head fake. Down the lane he goes. Pass to Corzine. Didn't want to take the shot. Daly does. Misses on it. Mitchell with a rebound. Kicks it out quickly to Paxton. Looking down the court. He had Roberts out in front. They couldn't quite get the ball to him. Jump shot by Mitchell. Woo.
It's a little hurry-up offense here now, and a good job by the Spurs.
Mitchell now has seven, and the Spurs have taken their first lead of the game.
So they get Artis out, and they get Gervin out, and that are some shots for some of the other people.
And it's a quick lineup. Here's Sidney Green trying to post up on Mitchell. Fakes, goes up for the high arching jumper, and puts it right in. Sidney Green. He has his first two. Had a one-game visit to Kevin Lockery's doghouse after that travel incident. when he missed a plane, but now Kevin said today, hey, he's out of it. He served his sentence, and that's it. Bulls have the rebound after the miss. They'll go to break the tie. Jordan. Wes Matthews, covered by Paxson. Daly coming around the screen. Paxson stole the ball, trying to pass it to him. Bulls will have to get back on defense. Ozell Jones, look out. Ozell Jones gave a good stress test to that rim as he rammed home his first two of the game.
Bulls did not look good on their set play offense. They're telegraphing the ball. They know what they want to do, but they're just not making a good play.
Quentin Daly with a long one. Corzine trying to tip it up. Missed. The Spurs have the rebound, leading by two. 2 minutes old here in the second quarter. Paxson spinning through. Kicks it to Roberts. Long one. Brewer again. That Ron Brewer is a good little shooter from Arkansas. And a timeout is going to be taken, a 20. 20 taken by the Chicago Bulls. Kevin Lockery wants to check something. It does appear that the Bulls really aren't going through their plays very completely here, obviously.
No, they're not. And let's take a look at the stats in the first quarter. Bulls 48%, but the free throws have kept the Spurs in the game. Rebounding, the Bulls have done very well, 15-9 turnovers. And I thought all of those turnovers really were when the Bulls were going on a fast break to the basket, Bill. Let's take a look at this Ozell Jones. As I mentioned, he's given him a good job. He's 6'11 out of Cal State Fullerton. He goes in and around Corzine, up high, slams it. We'll take one more look. A good pass from Paxson.
High falling.
Down low. Makes the move inside, up, and he does a good job backing up Artis Gilmore.
He was a teammate of Leon Woods at Cal State Fullerton, Ozell Jones, so he comes from a good program. Bulls have it back. Jordan missed on the shot. The rebound comes out. San Antonio has it. The Spurs on top by four. Jordan with a steal. Driving.
Well, he missed a long one. He stole the ball, went up and played slam. Thank you, man.
And so now it's a two-point game again. Spurs on top here from the stadium. Bill Hazen and Johnny Carr with Sports Vision tonight. Happy to have you with us. You're going to follow a lot of Bulls basketball this year right here, so keep this dial spot in mind. Ozell Jones with a swinging hook. Green fighting for the rebound, and he got clobbered over the back.
Could be Mike Mitchell on it.
I think it was. Mitchell should get his second here. And that would be the first team foul.
I'm going to tell you something.
They give it to Paxson. No, they did give it to Mitchell.
Mike Mitchell, I'll tell you something. It's much more fun to watch this lineup that's in there now for San Antonio. Those other players are great, but these guys, they give you everything.
They give you a lot of hustle. Ozell Jones raises his hand, says, I got him.
That's me saying I'd rather see him play. I'm sure Cotton would rather have George Gervin in there than Artis Gilmore.
Yeah, but not if they're not playing well. Not if they're not playing well. Now Woolridge comes in. Daly goes out. That moves Jordan back into the back line. So Matthews and Jordan are that back court right now for the Bulls. Here's Matthews. In the lane. Woolridge driving. Spun it up off the rim. No. Rebound tipped out. Jordan goes up for it. Hanging in the air. We had a whistle. We had a whistle in there deep. Jordan appeared to be fouled as he was trying to swing through. And big Fred Roberts is the guy who got it.
All right, watch the hang time again. You don't know if he's going to shoot, pass it off, or what. He goes up, hangs. Finally gets hit by Roberts, and he'll get rewarded for two at the free throw line.
So Jordan will go into the foul line here, and he has 8 points to the moment tonight. I suppose of all the things, certainly one thing I've been very impressed with is his foul shooting. Came in leading the team at over 84%.
And he misses them early in the first three quarters. When it comes right down to the game, Bill, he is really, really top shelf.
Yeah, he doesn't miss when it counts. It just seems he has an uncanny ability there to hit them when they count. Ozell Jones on the wing. Brewer driving through the lane. Got the shot off. Jordan fouled him. Trying to deny him. Michael Jordan bumped him with a shoulder, and that's Jordan's first and the team's first in the second half.
All right, driving down the middle, Jordan comes up trying to block him. He does draw the body foul, and if I recall, I think Brewer got, I think his high is like 42 points.
Yeah, you're right.
Not with with San Antonio, but he got 42.
Yeah, he had 44 points in one game. You're right, Red. And he has reached, believe it or not, his season high with this team this year. He has five, and he just went over it, so he has a new season high. So Brewer's seeing a lot of action early. But you're right, a couple of years ago, he had that couple of big nights back-to-back. He had 39, 42, and then 44, all in back-to-back games. Brewer went in a real hot streak. Low Jordan turned around. He put it up. He almost put that. absolutely nuts on that. Roberts to Brewer. Banks. Roberts well covered in the paint. Brewer driving. Trying to tip it off. He walked with the ball. Brewer had a good step in there, but he traveled in the process. The ball goes over. The Spurs lead it by three. Bulls inbounds. Now they have full court pressure here. Woolridge comes up to the half court line, drops it off, and Wes Matthews into the forward court. Matthews does not have his pocket picked very much. Looking low for Sidney Green. They get it in there. Fade away. No shot this time. Porzingis fighting for the board. Got a tip in there. Rebound came up to San Antonio after the first tip. We have a whistle. Traveling. Paxson this time.
He gave a little skip right out at this way. Traveled over half court, and they called it.
Out of bounds, the Bulls bring it across the timeline here, trailing by three.
They got to break that time because that was a wide open three on two fast break.
Yeah. 5 minutes old, second quarter. Sidney Green had it blocked against the board. Banks at the other end. And it's a 5-point San Antonio lead. Banks has four on the night. This is the largest Spurs lead in the game.
Ozell Jones has done a job. We talk about blocked shots, and we thought it would be just Artis Gilmore, but Ozell Jones doing a job.
I'm out on the floor, 6:56 left in the second, and there's your score. Well, look who's here tonight. That's Roland Heeman on the right, Eddie Einhorn on the left, the White Sox Brain Trust.
Bill, I know you'd like to join me in welcoming the viewers of Group W Cable tonight's bowl game. You can take advantage of Sports Vision's new low price by calling Group W Cable 469-7557 today. Join Bill and I.
You betcha. We'd love to have you with us. I'll tell you, we're going to have an awful lot of excitement for you folks watching on Group W Cable, so give that number a call. Corzine with a turnaround. Nope, won't go down. Big Dave, after a good start, has gotten a little bit cool here. Spurs by five. This is a good offensive basketball team, the San Antonio contingent, I'll tell you. They're not 6-2 for nothing. Brewer, whoop, couldn't control it. Nine to shoot. Paxson, Fred Roberts, six to shoot. Oh, and Roberts puts it right in. Fred Roberts has his first two of the game. They got a basket out of thin air right there. They didn't have much to work with. Woolridge with a turnaround. Bulls are going cold. Batted around up there. Almost tipped in by Sidney Green. Long baseball pass out of the reach of Johnny Moore. No way. Or Banks. Brewer. He wasn't going to get to that.
2-for-13 field goal percentage in the second quarter. And I want to tell you something. Mr. Ozell Jones has had a lot to do with that. He's got a hand in everybody's face. Fred Roberts is not from Sesame, not from our neighborhood.
Yeah, I'll say. He's from a very tall neighborhood. Shot put up. It might have been deflected in there. And Ozell Jones comes out of there with it. Ahead to Paxson. Foul.
Michael Jordan, and I'll tell you, the Bulls have just getting their pockets picked. Their nose is wiped right in it here. All right, here's Paxson. He comes in. Jordan goes with the body, good move, ducking underneath, foul on Paxson.
So Paxson gets to the line, substitutions as Paxson comes in. We'll watch him here fire up a free throw to get on the board.
Ardenas Watley is in the game also. Sidney Green on the bench. Steve Johnson back in, and here comes Artis. He's had enough rest.
He got an early call to the bench.
Paxson has not missed a free throw, has he?
No, he's hit two straight here.
In the season. I think he's
you're right, he's
21 in the season.
Yeah. 24-20, Red, but he came in 18-18. He's added to that. So he's done very well. Now it is a 9-point Spurs lead. This is the largest lead that either team has had tonight. Bulls have gone very cold. Jordan driving. Yep.
Illegal D. And he says, you who?
Who's it on?
Illegal defense, San Antonio.
Okay, look, another going to keep Ozell Jones in the lineup. Ozell started to go to the bench. They're putting Banks, Gene Banks goes out.
So now you have Ozell Jones at a forward spot to play Steve Johnson. And Gilmore back in the middle against Corzine. Here is Michael Jordan, a long one. He sticks it. Michael Jordan goes and gets it.
That's only their third field goal. The last one they scored at the 9-14 mark, and that was about 4 minutes ago.
The Bulls have gone dry here for a little bit, and they paid the price for it against this good offensive team. Paxson down the lane. He got loose in there.
Went across the lane, switched to his right hand, and drove right down the middle. And Kevin says, come on, Dave, you got to help us out.
John Paxson came in averaging 11 points. There were very high expectations when he came out of Notre Dame. And it's taken him a little longer to develop than his brother. Woolridge out, and he take it to Ozell Jones.
That's right. That was no layup. Ozell wasn't expecting that one.
In your face. Spurs by 7. 4:38 and counting here in the first half of play. Paxson faked to kick it off. Now he's a little caught. Fred Roberts. They have a 6'11", 6'11", 7'2 front line. Rebound comes out to the Bulls after the miss by Jones. Long pass. Jordan driving. He slams it right over the top of Ozell Jones.
Well, they put Ozell Jones into the forward spot. Michael Jordan came down. Turn into Captain Marvel again. Watch him come down. Now watch 8 slide over near screen. He sees him up, up, up. They both go and up, powering over the top. Not only has he got that jumping ability, he's got the strength. Here we get one more angle at it. A good angle. That's over a 6'11", man.
Missed on the three-point play. Now it's a 5-point San Antonio lead. Paxson quickly up there. This is the biggest lineup that San Antonio can field. 7-2, 6-11, and 6-11. Now we had a whistle away from the ball as Corzine and Gilmore got tied up, and they gave it to Big Dave. That's his first personal foul and the third team foul on the Bulls for the quarter.
You talk about their biggest lineup, and they didn't even have George Gervin in there. Now Gervin comes in, and they don't lose anything, right?
No, they certainly don't. Corzine to the bench, and Caldwell Jones comes back in. Here is Paxson. Feed Gervin. Look at him down the lane. Drops it off. Ozell with a slam. An easy two for Ozell Jones, who has four.
You see, to call him the Iceman. Did you see how easy he did that? He just drove the lane very easily. Let people duck by him. He underhanded it to Ozell, and he slammed it.
Easy two. Here's Jordan. Bulls trail by 7. Caldwell Jones. Hands it to Watley. He'll take the shot with 6 on the shot clock, and in as Watley puts it in. He has 6 for the game. And the Bulls now trail by 5. And what has been a very high-scoring first half, and it's been one of these end-to-end type games. Each team has been trying to fast break on the other. Roberts on the wing. Woolridge is covering him. Gilmore in traffic went up for it. Just powered it in there. And Caldwell Jones could not deny him.
A look at a move we talked about. The coaching staff wants to deny him of this play. Artis came across the middle, faked that hook to the left, and came back, and powered, leans into the right. It's a tough thing to block.
And being a left-hander, it causes all that much more difficulty because he's coming back right at you. So when he goes up for that jump shot, he's just right on top of you. He's so strong, he can just power it over people. Here's a lob. Jordan caught it and really jammed it down home. Michael Jordan for 15. The backdoor lob, and Jordan was open.
Well, he needs some help, though. We got to get him some help. Open it up a little bit.
Spurs in the front court. They lead it by 6. Paxson driving. Blocked against the glass. Caldwell Jones with a nice block shot. Jones will put it down. Now kicks it to Watley in the Bulls. Watley driving. Nice pass off to Steve Johnson. He wasn't anticipating it. And the Spurs come up with it on the turnover. Ozell Jones, Gervin, look out. Missed on the shot. Kept alive by Jones. Head fake. He traveled. The ball goes over.
I'm glad that was Ozell Jones that did that, not Gervin, because Gervin would have had that basket in and no travel call.
Timeout Spurs with 2.5 minutes left for the quarter. It's the Spurs by 6. While the Spurs continue to hold on to a steady 6-point lead here at the stadium.
Best ticket in town welcomes the viewers of Warner Amex to the Bulls telecast. For all this action at a new low price, call Warner Amex Cable at 577-1818 and ask for Sports Vision.
Check us out. Check out that new low price. I think you'll be pleased with what you get. We have many, many events, including a number of Bulls games, the Hawks, Northwestern. Offensive foul here away from the ball. And it's on Watley, and the Bulls give up possession. His third. Ball goes over. Down to 2:22 left here in the first quarter of play. You see, the Bulls dominated things, or at least controlled them in the first quarter, but boy, the Spurs come back with a good second quarter performance here at the stadium. Low feed, nice pass. Blocked by Jordan as Paxson tried to put it up. Jordan came across. Here are the Bulls. Counterattacking. Jordan underneath goes up for it. Foul. As he tried to put it in, Fred Roberts trying to deny him, and he picks up personal number 2.
Well, he just watch the block shot. Now here's the pass. Artis Gilmore lays it up, and block shot by Jordan, and now he beats it down the court. He gets a ball that won't come up off the floor. He manages to get control, go up in a crowd. I think it's Roberts that got up. The ball went up, and he missed it. And Kevin Lockery, during that, what we were just showing you, he went to work on Steve Jassy. That's your responsibility. Don't let that man cut down the middle like that. Fred Roberts on the foul.
So Jordan will go to the line. Well, this game has been you would agree, would you not, Red? They gave a previous offensive foul to Caldwell Jones to wipe one off of Watley's total. It's the one we told you was Watley's. It actually was Caldwell Jones. And Jordan misses a free throw, and that's the first time I've seen him frustrated with himself. He was kind of disappointed with himself there. Dave Corzine back into the Bulls lineup. So Big Dave in there. Jordan has a 15-point first half. He's there with it, 16 now for the rookie out of North Carolina. Had 27 points, including the game winner against the Indiana Pacers. Down to 2 minutes left for the quarter. Second quarter of play from the stadium in Paxson. George Gervin, high screen from Gilmore, looking inside for the big guy. It's way up there. Gilmore got it easy.
That's why he leads the league in field goal percentage. Yeah. Pop for two, and he's got eight.
That time Jordan got rubbed off on Gilmore, and Jordan went a long way up there. But I'll tell you, when you're giving up about a foot to Gilmore, it's pretty tough to deny him. Woolridge going to the goal. Foul called as he put it down in the lane, and it's Fred Roberts again. That's his third. And with the bonus in effect, Woolridge goes to the foul line. That's a good look at Fred Roberts. He had a good summer camp, I understand. Played very well for the Spurs in their summer camp program. Mike Mitchell comes on for the Spurs, and Roberts goes out. Woolridge is there. 5 points. Below his average. Came in averaging 24-9. And he's there with both of those.
Good thing Michael Jordan came in the second quarter. The Bulls should have only about 5 points.
Yeah. Well, that's it. The Bulls have players that can pick up the slack. Here's Mike Mitchell. Lob for Gilmore. Look out in there. Johnson comes in, and he took the charge. Steve Johnson took the charge. And the Bulls have the ball back.
Right. Corzine had the front. Corzine was in front on a play. Hey, look what we got at halftime.
Hey.
I'll be here with Mel Daniels. You'll be there at the NBA Journal, and we'll have stats and highlights. And we haven't seen Mark McNamara in a long time since last year. Artis is going to sit down.
All right, you were going to say about the way they were defending.
Oh, that was a good job by Corzine. Okay, watch him. They're pulling out. And I see the big men all drifting out. Now watch a little two-on-two basketball here.
A little isolation here. And foul call. Jordan was coming around. And Paxson got hung up in the pick. And he committed the foul. That's his first, and that'll put Jordan on the line. There's Mark McNamara, who just came in. Third year from Cal.
Okay, the last time Artis Gilmore tried to get the ball down low, Corzine fronted him, and then Steve Johnson came behind him. When Artis went to make his move, he just piled over the top of Steve Johnson and picked the foul up.
17 points for Jordan, and the Bulls have clawed back. They were once 9 down. Now they're 4 down, and they could cut it down still more. They do. Jordan with an 18-point first half, and the Bulls are on the move. They pulled it back to within 3. We're down to 1:05. You know, the Bulls got way out in front in the first quarter and then fell behind. Now here's Gervin driving. Oh, what a move.
Soft underhand, huh?
That's his first 2 points of the quarter, however. He has 14 for the quarter, and it's the Spurs by 5 with 53 seconds remaining. Second quarter of play. Daly. Bulls are going to click off some time here. They want to get a 2-for-1 if they can. Daly goes right over Gervin. Missed on the shot. Rebound comes out to Mike Mitchell. Make the baseball pass. That's the situation. Well, I'll tell you, I hope they're not getting used to seeing that. He has a different way of jamming them every time. They're going to go for one now.
Well, hold on. Watch him. Keep your eye on Gervin. He's nowhere yet. He's got Michael Jordan on him. They're going to post him up.
He's trying to. Jordan. See, he has both arms up in the air, trying to deny it. See the time to
illegal.
Shoot.
Illegal.
Illegal defense warning against the Bulls. Each team now has one.
They did not want Gervin to get the last shot. All right, let's see what happens. It's a technical foul. Is it the second one? I thought that was the first one.
I thought that was the first one, too, but apparently not. I thought they gave the last one. Apparently they did give them both to Chicago. And Gervin will get a tech. You talk about a soft shot. I don't know of anybody. 22nd timeout will be taken by San Antonio. They had held on to their 20. and they still haven't. You know, I kind of wonder now, with 3 seconds left, as to who they would go to with a four-point lead now. And, you know, Durbin has that tremendously soft shot. I don't know if I've ever seen a softer shot than Durbin has. He just rolls him in every way.
He's unreal, but I would sure keep an eye on John Paxton. He's got that long range also, so you know they'll be double-teaming George Gervin, and Gervin will give the ball back. They throw it into him. He can't get it. He'll just one-hand it back to the man. There's Johnny Moore came in the game also, so they're looking for some big shooters. They got good shooters out there now with Ozell Jones, who will, I'm sure, go right to the basket.
All right. It'll be inbounded by Mitchell. Here's Moore inside three-point range. Lofts it up. Nope, wouldn't go. That ends the half. And the Bulls have fought back to trail by only four after being behind by as many as nine in the second quarter. Well, the Chicago Bulls have a little work to do this second half as they currently trail by four here at the Chicago Stadium. Let's take a little look at the breakdown here on the half. And I'd say the shooting tells a lot of this story. Rebounds pretty close to even here, right?
Let's take a look at the field goals. Well, the Bulls did score two more. And in that free throw situation, almost perfect from the line, 16 out of 17. From the free throw, and the only miss by Gilmore, and that was the first free throw of the game, so they've got quite a string together.
Done a very good job. Bench points also of interest.
Well, you see that 16-8. I predicted it the other way around. I think it's really 16-10.
Ozell Jones certainly has been a factor, regardless of what he scored.
Well, Daly was only 2 for 9 coming off the bench, and I did not figure on that in my calculations. I figured he'd be a little bit better than that.
Well, you see, you have to fine-hone those calculations there, Red, and usually in a game, especially when he was 14-19 against Indiana, you'd figure that would be the case, wouldn't you?
Right.
Third quarter action now. The Bulls have it to start the third. They trail by four. Here is Whatley. It goes to Woolridge, takes the shot, and sticks it right away. Orlando Woolridge hits his first. Woolridge had just 6 points for the half. That doesn't figure into the calculations very well either, as he came in averaging nearly 25 points a game. Here's Gervin. Ice trying to back down through the lane.
Look at that underhand. Oh, he's so big, he takes the ball on the way up, just underhands it in. Beautifully done.
And it's the Spurs by four. Watley and Jordan in the backcourt. Woolridge and Steve Johnson at the forwards. Caldwell Jones in the middle. Woolridge, covered by Banks, goes to Jordan. Had trouble controlling it. Low feet Steve Johnson trying to move in. The fadeaway on Gilmore won't go down. Jordan in there. No, he lost it going up in a period. Didn't quite control it. The baseball pass to Gervin from Banks. Driving. Basket. And a foul.
The ice man again with his 19th point. Oh, watch. I think, who was that on?
Watley they gave it to before he got to Steve Johnson.
He hesitated. Slow. He didn't take it full bore, Louis, to the hoop. He just hesitated, and then threw the foul. Steve Johnson came over to help out. It worked out that way.
Gervin now has 20, and boy, he has really cast down the gauntlet this third quarter.
You got to remember, if he gives up that spot on the All-Pro team, he may give it up to number 23 on the other team. He doesn't want to do that without a fight.
He certainly does not. Watley goes right around Gervin, driving, and gets the basket.
He made some contact there, but
nothing called. On where it said Blaine Reichel, it was right there. Didn't see a foul. So the Spurs, well, right now, a five-point lead. Johnny Moore.
Uh-oh. Oh, we up. Jordan couldn't get out of the way, cutting down a lane. And Mitchell draws a foul, and they don't want, Kevin doesn't want him to get in foul trouble that way.
Michael Jordan picks up personal number three, and the Bulls have two quick team fouls here. The Bulls bench wanted that ball over the end line. They wanted a turnover. Gervin driving. Missed on the scoop, but he got his own rebound. How is he getting in there so deep?
He's making a penetration. He's not getting any help from the other Bull players.
And now the Spurs up on top by seven again. Steve Johnson covered by Gilmore. Woolridge driving into the paint. Takes it. Doesn't make it. Long rebound. Woolridge driving again. That's diving on it. Orlando Woolridge with 10, and the Bulls realize they're going to have to get some players going now. Gervin quickly moving, and Watley with a foul. He tried to deny him going to the basket, tried for the steal. Watley has four. Third team foul, common foul.
Just nice and easy does it, reaching around the back. Daly's going to come in now, and They will continue to go to Gervin with the ball. Whether he shoots it or passes it off, he will be handling it an awful lot.
Enos Watley will sit down. Daly. Now you have Jordan covering Gervin in the lane. Gilmore trying to move to the hoop. And boy, he doesn't power right in on Caldwell Jones. Orlando Woolridge got the foul coming in from the side. That's his second. And the fouls here, Red. And the Spurs have not committed any.
That's right. Just a shade under 10 minutes left in this period.
So Gilmore, who has 8 points to the moment. I'll tell you something. These Spurs are going to hurt a lot of people. They are really strong. They look like the team of 2 years ago that really was on a rampage in this league.
The only thing that surprises me is they're 1-2 on the road. That one game they got was against New York, and it was an overtime game, and New York did not have their two centers.
Yeah, that's right. That is rather surprising. Johnson, low feed, went into traffic, stolen away. The Spurs have it. Johnny Orr, bounce pass to Mitchell. Here he goes. No, Gilmore kept it alive with a good rebound. Goes up, no. Coming back. Moore kicks it out. Look out. Gervin's wide open. Gervin was 24. And the Bulls are going to have to call a timeout as this game is showing signs of getting away from them. A 9-point Spurs lead. Timeout on the floor. The ball now as we return to play. Jordan almost lost it. Tipped over the sideline and out of bounds. San Antonio gets it right back. The Spurs have outscored the Bulls 11-6 beginning the third quarter here.
9-2, two free throws by Artis, 9 points by Gervin, and that's it, Billy. You're right.
Nice and simple. They've gone to their two big gunners. Moore spinning through, too hard off the glass. Gilmore lost it. He was right there for the rebound, but he just couldn't grab it. He could not grab it. And the Spurs have had their intimidators out there tonight, as you can tell from the block shot totals. One way, San Antonio. They have one of the biggest teams. When they have Roberts in there, and their other 6'11 man, they have one of the biggest teams in the league. Johnson with a swinging hook shot from the baseline, puts it in. And Steve Johnson has 10 points. Bulls claw back within seven. Moore in the forecourt, picked up by Quentin Daly. Bulls will have to do a job defensively here. Daly backs off after Moore stops his dribble. Here's Gervin, fires over Woolridge. Misses, rebound tipped around, and the Bulls come out with it. Here's Jordan over the time. And the ball came loose, nothing was called. Jordan got it back. And a fresh 24 as the Bulls have it across. Here's Quentin Daly driving into the paint. Goes for it. No, Woolridge with a rebound. The fake. Kaboom!
I can't understand that. No call at half court. Two players went down. The ball rolled around, but Orlando salvaged the day for the Bulls.
It is a 5-point Spurs lead. Cut Fitzsimmons up off the bench, shouting the play he wants his team to run.
First time we've heard defense chanted here in the stadium in a long time.
Yeah, the low lob to Gilmore. Look out. Jones pushed it from the back. My goodness. After all of what we've just seen, they picked that one to call.
Well, Blaine Reichel is not one of my favorites, although I would like to wish one of my favorites a real speedy success, and that's Jack Madden, who went down and had knee surgery, one of the best officials in the league. And we sure hope that Jack can get back out of his hospital bed. I know he won't be doing many more if he does any games this year, Bill, but I know you join me in wishing him that speed.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And a very speedy recovery. We look forward to seeing him back out when he's ready. Gilmore misses. The bonus is in effect now for the Spurs at 7:36. San Antonio has not committed a team foul. So the Spurs, with that formula they've used in the first half, they're getting to the line. And they're making the Bulls pay for it at the foul line. Gilmore now has 11. And all but four of that has come from the foul line. So seven of his points, of his 11 points, are from the foul line. Here's Woolridge. Quentin Daly, he'll take the shot over Gervin and puts it in.
Boy, they need to get Q hot.
They need to get him going. Banks in the forecourt. And it is the Spurs by four. Banks looking inside, the low lob. Here's Gilmore in there deep. The shot was blocked, partly deflected. A foul called. The basket counts.
All right, that's a half of position. They try to get the ball out to Gilmore now. The man, Quentin Daly, doesn't go all the way back and threaten Moore with the shot. You've got to either make the guy on the outside take the shot, Bill. You can't get caught in between, and you do, you give Artis a three-point play.
And that's just what happened. Gilmore indeed hits that three-point play, and now he has 14. And the Spurs are digging in here. They now lead it by 7. Quinton Daly, Durbin is on him. Feed low to Corzine. He'll look for the hook over the middle. Might have been blocked. It was by Gilmore. Just got a hand on it. Counterattack. Banks, the ball went off his shoulder. He got it back. No! And the Bulls come out of there with it. Lead to Jordan. Spinning. He'll take it. He makes it. Michael Jordan with his first two of the second half.
Well, you see him there. 6 on Chicago, 9 on San Antonio. Very important.
Yeah, the bonus light has been on for San Antonio since 7:36. We're down to 6.5 remaining here in the third. Johnny Moore. Wow, back door. Back. It was blocked. Steve Johnson blocked the shot. Here's Daly. What a
pass.
What a block by Steve Johnson, and then what a pass by Michael Jordan to Daly. And that brings these Bulls fans to life. Timeout on the floor. It's the Spurs by 3.
Here's the block. Steve Johnson and a good block. Banks up high. Steve came from nowhere to slap that ball away. Good job. Since the Bulls turned over the ball at 9:09, they've held San Antonio to one field goal. That by Artis Gilmore on a breakaway shot.
Outscored them 10-4, I guess, in that little streak, haven't they, Red?
Yeah, and you mentioned we're going to see Larry Bird this week and Julius Erving, two heavyweight champs.
Yeah, that's right. They were in a recent slugging session. Don't forget Moses Malone in there. Mitchell, and Mike Mitchell comes back and gets a big basket for his Spurs. His first points in the third quarter. It's back to a 5-point San Antonio lead. Here come the Bulls now. Under 6 minutes left, third quarter. Daly. Look, Steve Johnson's open in there. If he can get the shot off. Nope. And the rebound came out to Gilmore. And they got locked up. Gilmore and Johnson got locked up there deep. Here's Ozell Jones. He missed the dunk. I think Corzine may have blocked it at rim level. He just got a hand on it.
I think he hit his wrist anyway. It's a travel. They said to keep the clock running. That's what he was signaling.
All right, here's a pass underneath. And Artis Gilmore now has 16 points. He's had a big quarter for the Spurs with 7. Boy, they're going to him and he's scoring. Now it's the Spurs by 7 again, and the Bulls need baskets. Woolridge up high to Steve Johnson. Looking low. Woolridge driving. Pump fakes. But the big man was there to intimidate him. And the Spurs come out with it. Feet into traffic and a foul. Ozell Jones over the back of Woolridge, who made the steal.
Let's take a look at Ozell as he gets up off the floor. We'll replay something. He goes in to take the shot. Now let's see if Corzine hits him on the wrist. Oh, he got just a piece of the ball. Hey, wait a minute. He fouled me.
Didn't look as if he touched him on that.
Ozell got called for the foul. Orlando Woolridge is back. Only one foul, team foul on the Bulls.
Here is Corzine.
I mean, on the
Spurs.
Spurs.
Daly manages to get it inside. Corzine with a fake, lays it up. It won't go down.
Johnson grabbed Ozell Jones's jersey, held him down.
Here is Moore to Gervin. Woolridge is covering Gervin now. Daly stole the ball. The Bulls. Orlando driving, lays it up. Foul. He was fouled by Johnny Moore.
I wish we had a little of that highlight on that missed shot. All right, here it is. Q gives the ball over to Orlando. Orlando gathers it in. He wants to slam it, but he has to take it right in over Johnny Moore.
All right, and Johnny Moore, as you can see, notching just his first personal foul. Woolridge to the line. Has a 6-point quarter, 12 for the game. Now 13. Red, will you comment a little bit about the change in defensive attitude? Woolridge is now covering Gervin.
Well, he's got to try to keep him from getting the ball. That's about all he can do.
And that leaves a mismatch somewhere else on
right.
The floor, does it not?
That's right, it sure does.
Here's Johnny Moore. They double-team him.
Jardis just hanging around the goal.
Johnny Moore goes by Daly. Feed to Mitchell. Goes up over his man, and it goes down. Mike Mitchell was open. The Bulls trying to put extra pressure on, and Mitchell was open, and he has 11. That's what the Spurs can do to you. San Antonio by 8. Now we have a whistle in traffic here. And Ozell Jones.
He is not going to get a break tonight, Bill.
No, he sure
is getting
not.
His jersey pulled. He's been had a shot blocked around the rim. Been up and down. And now Gene Banks will come off the bench and say, hey, Rook, sit down and cool it off. There's Ronnie Lester. He's still on the injured reserve list sitting on the end of the Bulls bench.
Quentin Daly with the inbound pass. Here's Jordan around the screen. Three-point opportunity as Moore fouled him. He got around the screen late, and
he's strong enough.
Yeah.
He's so strong, he held onto it because Johnny Moore had put some good pressure on him. Scotty Robinson just went over and talked to Ozell Jones and patted him on the back and said, listen, everything's going wrong. Don't worry about it. Keep in there. Things will fall right for you. Good job by Scotty. And Jordan knocks in a three-point.
25 points for Michael Jordan. And the out of bounds of San Antonio. By the way, Scotty Robertson, former Bulls coach, wanted to say hello to everybody in the Chicago area. I was talking with him before the game here. He's one of the really nice people in this game. And he has so many fond memories of people around here, and he wanted to be sure to say that he inquired and wanted to pass along best wishes to everybody. Oh, there's Mitchell with another one. He has 13.
He's got the last three from the same spot. The Bulls better wake up. They know he can shoot from there.
Here's Jordan looking on the near side. They're trying to look for Steve Johnson. Johnson has a mismatch situation with Mike Mitchell. Here's Jordan. He's going to take one, and he puts it in. Jordan has 27, and he's come to life. And now it is a five-point Spurs lead. San Antonio with the ball. The Bulls are going to have to figure out something here defensively. Here's Gervin. He got loose in there. Puts it up. Offensive foul. Offensive foul. The ball goes over as Gervin ran into traffic.
Good job. Steve Johnson is really getting a good job. You know, he's playing well with that sore heel. There it is. A good move by the Iceman. He crosses over on, takes it right in the rims. And he, good move on Quentin Daly. Started to his right and came left. Packs it in for Gervin. Gervin will sit down, get a little fine time now. The Bulls with a chance. Tighten it up here.
All right, we're down to 3 minutes left here in the third quarter, and Jordan brings it into the forecourt. Covered by Johnny Moore. Up top, Woolridge gets it. Looking for the screen from Corzine. Pass to Corzine. Stolen right out of his hands by Johnny Moore. Moore driving. Behind the back pass, Banks. We had something traveling called on Moore. And the Bulls dodge a bullet. They get the ball back.
Johnny Moore very interested in getting his assist that time. He could have gone right up with it. He laid it off to Banks over pass and a travel call. Bulls want some action here to Bulls fans.
Moore is averaging over 9 assists a game. And there may be some merit to your point of view on that, Red. Wants to get the stats. Here's Daly in the paint. Quentin Daly now has 10.
He's got to come to life.
Bulls need a big game out of him. Here's Mitchell. He'll fire. Misses. Bulls can cut it to one if they score. Here's Jordan down the middle all the way.
Oh. Look at this crowd. Look at this crowd up on their feet. He went right down the middle on Artis Gilmore. Slammed it over the top of the big man.
And a timeout will be taken by the San Antonio Spurs, and this crowd has come alive. Remaining here in the quarter with the San Antonio Spurs. Red just told me to take my earphones off so I could hear this. I think you thought we went away for a break. We're going to pause. We will take that break.
No, here it is.
All right.
There's the slam on the break. Listen to this crowd. They're on their feet. It was a 20-second timeout. They took. Listen to this crowd. Michael Jordan getting them going. I haven't heard anything. This is a great place to play basketball. The Chicago Stadium. Been around a long, long time. Everybody on their feet here. And Captain Marvel comes back again. Running down. Watch, he's got Artis Gilmore on the back pedal. Up, 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 and away.
He just went, flew right by Gilmore, left him in the dust. Low feed to Artis. 12 seconds to shoot. They double team him. Look at the Bulls working defensively. Corzine won't give him any room.
Traveling.
Corzine did not give him any room on the baseline. He shut him off cold.
Remember this, viewers, as you're going down a stretch, you have not seen the Bulls lose on Sports Vision this year, preseason or regular season.
That's right. And there's the story on turnovers, and now the Bulls trying to drive, and as Daly was going to the hoop, he got hacked. That should put the bonus light on. It was Paxson who gets it.
Listen
That's
to this.
Second.
Michael Jordan gets a little break here. He needs it. Boy, they give it some. Listen to this.
And Wes Matthews come in as his replacement. There's Michael Jordan sitting down. The Bulls finally go to the bonus. at 154. San Antonio had the bonus for almost 6 minutes longer than the Bulls, and yet the Bulls are in a situation where they come back and now tied this game.
All right. George Gervin comes in now for Johnny Moore, I believe, and you're going to see Gervin with the ball. They're going to try to open this back up, but Q was able to tie it. He's got to get the hot hand. He'll go to him a little bit again, as I mentioned.
Daly with one more. He puts it right down. He has 12 points. Eight of those in this quarter. And now it's the Bulls by a point, and they have fought all the way back from a nine-point deficit twice in this game. Paxson to Gervin. Bulls buzzing around like bees, and Paxson sticks a long one. John Paxson breaks the tie. He has six. Down to a minute 35 of the quarter, and the Spurs by a point. Matthews. Feed. Daly driving through. Lofting a shot up to Johnson with a rebound. Steve Johnson with a rebound, and it counts.
Jake O'Donnell, you saw him swinging. Yes, yes, yes. He took it from away from the rim and slammed it down home.
So if there was any doubt about offensive goaltending, Jake O'Donnell waved that right off. Minute 10 remaining. Bulls by a point. Mike Mitchell, double team. Look at the pressure the Bulls are putting on. Paxson's open. Down low, Banks going in. Nice sweeping hook shot. Baskets are starting to come a little harder now for San Antonio.
Sure are.
It's the Bulls trailing by a point. Matthews with it, 53 seconds left. How much time will they kill here? 16 on the shot clock. Can they go for a two-for-one? Daly. Matthews is open. A long one. Banks with a rebound. And the Spurs could go up by three if they score. Paxson. Feed low. Look out. Gervin in there. Whistle.
No shot.
Boy.
Orlando followed him down a lane. Boy, you can't let him get anywhere near that painted area. You try to keep him away from that. That's third on Orlando Woolridge. And Gervin will go to the line and just up this very quickly. They want to get Artis Gilmore out now for this 35-second. A lot of jockeying going on by the two coaches and trying to get their players that little extra rest. And I'm sure Kevin Mockery said, please try to hold it close. Can we get Mike a little rest?
Yeah. You know, something that may hurt the Spurs tonight is that they're playing without Edgar Jones. He didn't make the trip, so they're a little short on the bench, right?
You know, and this is also the first of four games in five nights for this ball club. And I'm sure Scotty or
Cotton Fitzsimmons.
Would like to rest his troops too. Can't burn them out in that first time out the gate.
Yeah, you're right. Down to 30 seconds remaining in the half or in the third quarter here as the Spurs by three. Wes Matthews, low lob, Corzine in there. McNamara hit the ball, knocked it out of bounds. 13 to shoot, 23 on the game clock. Now we have substitution, Sidney Green in the Bulls lineup.
Gervin did what they wanted, gave him a couple points. He goes and sits down and grabs a little extra time for a rest.
Sidney Green replaces Steve Johnson in the Bulls lineup. Woolridge inbound. Daly can cut it to one. He does. Quentin Daly hits him from all over. And he is an eight-point third quarter. Bulls now trailing by a point to San Antonio. And the Spurs are holding for the final shot.
You got to go to Mitchell. Mitchell's their shooter out here now.
9 seconds. Paxson with 5 seconds. Paxson in the lane with 3 seconds. Laid it off to McNamara, and he gets the hook. McNamara with his first two, and with 2 seconds left, the Bulls. The clock has stopped. The Bulls will inbound. Goes to Sidney Green. A three-pointer block. Blocked by Banks, and with that, the third quarter comes to an end. And the Spurs have a three-point lead going into the final stanza. The stands here tonight, written among them, Mark Roth is one of the top PBA bowlers as a friend here tonight. The Brunswick Memorial World Open going on right now at the Brunswick Northern Bowl in Glendale Heights. And Mark Roth currently in third. That's a $150,000 tournament. So we welcome Mark. Here's a drive inside. Tipped away. Paxson. Mitchell came up with it. Misses on the shot. Tipped against the board. Banks with a rebound. Kicked out front to Paxson. And it is Banks. Inside.
Good job of rebounding that time by the San Antonio.
Nice cut by Paxson.
Good play by Banks. Top of the key, the big veteran went outside, looked for somebody to hit in the backdoor basket of Johnny Paxson.
Now it's 5 lead for the San Antonio Spurs. We're in the first minute of play, fourth quarter. Sidney Green hands it to Wes Matthews. The Bulls will run the offense. They have 10 seconds to shoot. Here's Woolridge driving the baseline. Goes up in the air. Was blocked by Banks. Foul, Banks. And that is his second personal foul, first personal foul, I have it. Or is it number two? Number two, yeah. Okay, and first team foul on the Spurs in the fourth quarter, and Woolridge gets to the line. He has 13 on the night. Spurs have really helped themselves from the foul line, and the Bulls are going to need a good quarter from the foul line to stay right in there.
Remember that first half, they were 16 out of 17. Yeah. The opening free throw missed by Gilmore, and then a rush.
Woolridge now has 15, and the Bulls pull it back within three again. Here's Paxson. Bulls could use some turnovers if they can force them there. Paxson with Wes Matthews on him. Got a mismatch here somewhere. Bulls trying to cover defensively. Corzine got well out of position. Now here's a jump shot, missing the mark. Ball tipped toward the sideline, out of bounds. Whose ball? San Antonio's. They'll get another shot at it.
It's two in a row now that the Bulls have given up. The shot has been missed, and San Antonio came up with the rebound. The first time by Banks. That time it was tipped out of bounds by the Bulls. You've got to come up with those.
Paxson with the inbounds pass.
Michael Jordan in the game again.
Yes, Jordan just checked it. Here's Ron Brewer firing, misfiring. Sidney Green takes a rebound for Chicago. Uplifted to Wes Matthews down the lane. Offensive foul Matthews as he ran into Paxson. Wes Matthews with his first personal foul of the game.
Here he comes. A good move by John Paxson. You gave it the O, but he was there enough time to cause that turnover. And Wes Matthews runs to the bench. Mo Watley back in the game.
So the Bulls now getting their starters slowly but surely back in here. Quentin Daly still in the lineup for the Bulls. Sidney Green still in, and Corzine. Here is Mitchell around the screen. Fires over Corzine. No. Rebound McNamara in there deep.
Corzine went out on Mitchell. Got a good hand up, but Sidney Green was late. And you're going to see, if you're paying for that mistake, you'll see Steve Johnson come back in for Sidney Green.
And Caldwell Jones up off of the bench. He'll come on for Corzine. Bulls have to go to their first unit here. Here, Jordan firing a long one. Dumps it right in. Michael Jordan with 31. And the Bulls pull back to the three-point deficit here. Paxson in the forecourt. Spurs with mostly a second unit on the floor. At least they're playing without Gervin and Gilmore right now. They can bring them back when they need them. Brewer fed to Mitchell. He's double-teamed. Six to shoot. Mitchell traveling. The Bulls get it back.
Called for a turnover, Bill. You got it.
That's what they're going to need to get them back in it. And here's the story on the how that third quarter broke down. Look at the field goal percentages. They've been high. And the rebounding, San Antonio dug in to get a couple edge. Just a very good shooting game all the way across. 9.5 minutes left in our ball game from the stadium tonight. Backdoor feed. Daly's open. Perfect feed from Enes Watley. And Quentin Daly has 16, and the Bulls have come roaring back within a point. Paxson in the fourth court. Up off of the bench comes the Iceman. He's ready to step back in. Paxson, covered by Watley. He almost traveled with it, got it to Banks. I thought he might have
traveled too.
Shuffle stepped there a little bit. He seemed to slip.
Paxson can run this ball club. He is a smart, good guard.
Oh, and Jordan blows right by Banks like he was standing still. Michael Jordan with a total of 33 points. They're going to need a big night out of him. His career best is 37 in a Bulls uniform.
Oh, he just missed the steal.
Paxson, low feed to Mitchell. Goes up for it. Shot clock. Jordan foul.
Well, nobody likes it here, but Jordan went up and tomahawked the ball. He could have just gone up and gently taken it with his left hand. Watch it. It's too dramatic a shot here. He goes up in the air.
They gave it to Johnson.
Well, okay.
Steve Johnson picked up his fourth. But Jordan, we could see where we're sitting. We could see Jordan come in from the back very clearly.
You'd like to see him sort of go up and just pick that ball out of his hand. Grab it. I don't like to see him lose Steve Johnson.
No, certainly not.
I would hope that the Bulls would be very close to doing something with David Greenwood. They need that stability of the veteran in the lineup, and they miss him. The Bulls have done a sensational job without him of patching up and picking each other up.
Mitchell at the line. He hits it. He has 14 points now on the night.
Go!
That's the story. Boy, what an offensive player this guy was. And certainly he was never better than against the Bulls. He really hurt the Bulls last year.
Came into his own with a very poor team, the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yeah. And was a standout with a missed the shot. And the Bulls have a rebound. They can tie with a basket. Here they come. 3.5 minutes old in the fourth quarter. Enes Watley. play, covered by Gervin, drives around him all the way. Enes Watley has 10, and the Bulls have tied it at 96.
Now there's good balance, Bill. We've got Q on a backdoor layup, Watley down the middle, Jordan over the top, so everybody helping out.
The big man Gilmore's back in there, Gervin's back in.
Got to help down low to get Gilmore.
Moore, Gervin. Caldwell Jones trying to deny him. They get it in to Gilmore. Four to shoot. Three to shoot. Gilmore tips it off. Mitchell fires. Just beat the buzzer. Mike Mitchell just beat the buzzer. He has 16. And it's the Spurs by two. Here's Jordan. What a move to the baseline. He drives in. Passes off. Jones. Yes. Caldwell Jones has six. And the Bulls have tied it. Boy, these fans are getting revved up now. 7.5 minutes left in regulation.
All right, watch Iceman down low. Gilmore's way on the other side. He's taking advantage of Quentin Daly.
There's Iceman. Moore out front. Paid to Mitchell. To 3 seconds. Moore's going to have to shoot it. And Banks got to
beat him again.
Last minute, they beat the buzzer again.
They got two baskets in about 47 seconds, Bill.
Man.
They've stretched it all the way out.
That's what you call patience right there.
That's right.
Good ball club. Too much patience, I think. Spurs hit the century mark. Here's Watley driving in, and he's held. Gervin held him. George Gervin will pick up the foul. A timeout will be called by the Chicago Bulls with 6:58 left, and it's the Spurs by two. Now it's picked up a two-point score. That's it. Time remaining. We have virtually a dead-even game. Here's the Bulls have come back twice from nine-point deficits against this very, very tough San Antonio team. Bill Hazen back with Johnny Kerr here courtside, and boy, this is the action capital of the great Midwest right now, I'll tell you. The Madhouse on Madison Avenue. Whew. It's been fun.
It has, hasn't it been?
Yeah, this is, you know, this is the type of game the Bulls, even though the Spurs, I think, are playing very well, the Bulls still have a chance to win it, a very good chance.
I thought they could have folded a couple times here. Big streaks hit at them. On San Antonio, but Mo Watley now drew the foul on George Gervin. He's got a chance to tie it up here with a pair of free throws.
All right, Watley puts that first one in. If he hits another one, he has a new season high. He has 11 for the night. This ties his season high. He does it. Enes Watley with a dozen points, and almost all of them coming from the field. So he's hit some big jumpers. Now the score even at 100. And more. Here's Gervin. Look out. Puts it up. Caldwell Jones partially blocked the shot, I think. And the Bulls come flying out of there with it. Caldwell Jones just tipped it. Oh, Woolridge with a great move to keep it alive. Jordan! No, the rebound. Caldwell Jones foul underneath. Gilmore, I think, trying to keep him from putting it up. It is Gilmore, his fourth.
That is the open shot missed by Michael. And a try for a left-handed stuff by Caldwell Jones, and it was an off-ball foul, non-shooting foul by Artis.
Loose ball, they rule, and
here
so...
they come. See him coming out here, trotting out, the two men trotting out. That means you can open it up to go a little two-on-two basketball.
Jordan gets the screen from Caldwell Jones. Got caught in there. Whoa, what happened?
Got to jump it up. He had it.
George Gervin was probably wondering, hey, what are you guys doing around knee level here? Is Fred Roberts... dug in there, and Jordan dug in there. This will be a six-inch.
He's the smallest 6'11 guy you'll see, isn't he? Doesn't he look small, Fred Roberts?
Yeah, he does.
I don't see who gets the tip here. Jordan jumping with him.
6'6 Jordan, 6'11 Roberts. Jordan can go up and get these. We'll see. Up in the air. Jordan actually got higher. The tip was won by Roberts, and he controlled it in the circle. Moore. Spinning. Gervin. Gets it, and jumped. Steve Johnson got poked.
He jumped on top of Steve Johnson's head.
28 points for Gervin, and it's a 102-100 Spurs lead. The Bulls have not been able to get over the hump. They've clawed all the way back to tie it. They've been able to take the lead. Woolridge to Watley. Bulls playing for the tie again. Jordan, he'll take a long one. Michael Jordan with 35. He's within two of his career high in a Bulls uniform.
He'll be breaking that all year, I'm sure.
Yeah, he sure will. Gervin kicks it out to Moore. The head fake. High score at 102. Whistle.
3 seconds.
Oh, the Bulls get a break.
Oh, there's a stranger we haven't heard the whole game.
Yeah, you're right. And that has to be sweet music to the Bulls fans here at the stadium to hear it. The Bulls will inbound. Now, they have Steve. Johnson and Woolridge and Caldwell Jones up front. Jordan and Quentin Daly has just come back in for Enos Watley. Woolridge out front. Full score. They take the lead. Jordan, he'll go for it. He's tied his season high, and the Bulls have taken the lead. The first time they've led in a long, long time. And a timeout taken by the San Antonio Spurs, and the fans come to their feet for a standing ovation with 5:19 left. Yes, sir. There's some of the Bulls fans. From a long way back, they trailed by 9 twice in this game. They've come back red, and with the time remaining as you see it, Chicago's back on top again. And Johnny Kerr just got one of those small basketballs and flipped it into the stand. Good hook shot, Red, like the ones you used to make when you were playing in the league.
I think I threw my arm out of whack. You got to remember now, Michael Jordan, give him a 2-point lead. He's tied it up. He's got 8 out of 16 points in the fourth quarter. Bulls scored. 5:19 to go. Your first place Chicago Bulls are ahead.
These two teams have both surprised people in their division. I'll tell you, I think both of them are going to hurt a lot of people in this league. Bulls, if they win, will go 7-2. Whichever team wins this game will go 7-2, as a matter of fact, as the Spurs came in with an identical record. Here comes San Antonio. Now they trail.
This is as tough a team as they'll play. They got 3 games at home that are very, very tough.
Here's Ozell Jones to Mike Mitchell. Mitchell's covered by Jordan. Now Moore with a long one and ties it. Johnny Moore hits. He has 10 in double figures, and the Bulls come back with a 104-104 ball game. 5 minutes left. 5 minutes left. Orlando Woolridge. Feed to Jordan. Oh, what a move he just put on. Oh, what a move.
39, automatic.
39 points. Jordan has 10 for the quarter. Here's Moore. And the Spurs trail by 2 to the Bulls.
And the Spurs know they're going to him every time. Michael Jordan down low on the Iceman. Watch him.
Trying to keep the ball away. They did so. They went the other side. Mitchell off the glass and ties it again. He has 18 for the game. And we're tied at 106. And now, I'll tell you.
You know who they're going to, don't you?
Yeah, oh, no doubt. Here's Daly. Low lob, backdoor play. Steve Johnson, no! Got his own rebound. He was fouled in there. Ozell Jones and Artis Gilmore. It was on Ozell Jones.
Is it over the top? You want to see Steve get it, come down and lay it up, and he gets whacked. I thought he was shooting the ball. They're not going to give him the...
Thomas,
what was he doing?
So the bonus in effect, as you say, Red, that's very important. Woolridge has 15 points on the night. Ooh, and he misses a big one there. He'll have one more. Orlando's had a good game. Jordan with 39 here tonight. He got that second one, and the Bulls take a 1-point lead. Down under 4 minutes left in the game. Here come the Spurs. Moore. They have a whistle away from the ball. Let's see. Mitchell was trying to break free. They gave the foul to Steve Johnson. Here's the story on Jordan.
That looks like a football game, doesn't it? 6 in the first, 14. They missed a free throw. They got a safety and field goal and a touchdown so far here in the fourth.
Yeah. Steve Johnson picked up his 5th personal foul, according to my records. Here's Mitchell driving in, and he got the hoop, and he puts the Spurs back on top.
I said before, he's one of the best offensive forwards around, and boy, is he starting to prove it now.
I'll tell you, he has 20, and he's not afraid to put it up. He has no fear. Daly, a high arching jumper, won't go down, and Moore, the smallest man on the floor, got the rebound. Here's Gervin, kicks it across. Johnny Moore fires and hits. Johnny Moore wide open with a dozen, and the Bulls now find themselves 3 points down. They come into the forecourt. Jordan will bring it across. Johnny Moore will try to stop it. Now they double team. Kick it over. Daly penetrating. Off of the glass. No. Woolridge with the rebound. Goes up and gets the slam. Big basket for Orlando Woolridge. He has 18. And with 3 minutes left, the Spurs by a point.
A nail biter here again in the stadium.
I'll say, listen to these fans. Oh, I tell you, I can't wait to hear what it's like with 17,000 in here. Oh. George Gervin in the paint. Kicks it out. Moore is open. Missed the shot. Push off on
this
Banks.
Way.
I think a push off on Banks. Or is it?
Well, it looked like they're going to give it to Steve Johnson, I think.
Oh, well, Jones, they gave it
to him. How about that? Out here right in front of us, Bill, was...
Jake O'Donnell. And he said, stay right there. I thought Banks had a little bit of a shove. They give him the ball back, and that's what you want him to do. Dive by the sword, that outside shot. Moore missed it for him, but they got their...
Caldwell Jones has five personal fouls here, Red. He and Steve Johnson both playing with five, and you bet they'll try to feed it in here. It's lost, out of bounds. Sturman lost the ball.
Big, big play for Orlando Woolridge. You watch him come down the floor.
He put the big defense on Gervin and forced the turnover.
Put his hand right in there.
The Bulls can take the lead if they score. Quinton Daly. It goes to Woolridge. They have Jordan posted down on the baseline with Moore. Now he pops out. There's the ball for him. He takes the shot. 41 points for Michael Jordan. He has 12 points for the quarter. And it's the Bulls by a point at 111-110. We're approaching 2 minutes left of the game. Feed to Banks. Comes to Mitchell. Fires.
He missed one.
He missed it, by golly. He's human. He missed one.
All right, they're dying by that outside sword. Now Moore missed the last one, and there's a miss there.
Bulls across the timeline. Timeout. Timeout. Jordan, with the sound we had in here, did not hear it. The Bulls have called time. Bulls taking a timeout. There's a look at Michael Jordan. As you see, he's gone over his season high with 37. There's the score on the board. Man, what a game we've had tonight. That's the scoring by quarters. Look at how the Bulls have come on. They won that third quarter by a point. They have done a great job. Boy, are they hustling in this fourth quarter. And I'll tell you, now they've kind of pinned, they've taken it to the Spurs. They've pinned them back a little bit. The Spurs are going to have to be really careful. This could get away from them.
Jordan's got 10 points in the last minute and 40 seconds in this quarter.
Wow. 10 points at a minute 40. Bulls with the inbounds pass. All right, they have 12 seconds to shoot. Here's Quinton Daly. Will he try to take it? Woolridge comes out front. 7 seconds. Woolridge driving. Pulls up and takes it and hits it. Orlando Woolridge with 20 points. And the Bulls with a three-point lead. A minute 34 remaining in the San Antonio Spurs will call timeout here. And these fans have come to their feet. Don't give up anything easy. Make them work. I'll tell you, Red, if San Antonio, they hit two shots just inside the 24-second margin, you take away those two baskets, and Chicago has this game almost wrapped up at a minute 34.
I hate to mention this right now, but George Gervin has only 2 points in his quarter, and now Orlando Woolridge, acting like Sarge Matthews of the Cubs, rallying the fans around him. He said this could be our sixth man, and I haven't heard so much screaming and fun here at the stadium. Beautiful place to play basketball.
Oh, I'll say it is. And these fans, I'll tell you, the noise really echoes in here. It can get downright deafening. Fans came to their feet and gave the Bulls a standing ovation, as you saw. Spurs taking inbounds at the half-court line.
Bulls still have got one foul to take in the last 2 minutes.
Very important. Pass to Gilmore. Under pressure. Down goes Moore. Gilmore, he'll take the shot. That's not the one he wants to shoot. The rebound. The Bulls have it.
Jordan.
Michael Jordan got the rebound. Quinton Daly will bring it across. Now will the Bulls try to kill some time? We have a minute 10 left and 14 to shoot.
They're looking for Michael.
If the Bulls hit one here, it really counts big. Jordan lost it going up. Moore with a steal. Ahead to Banks. It was hit. It was kicked by Quinton Daly. Out of bounds to San Antonio.
Boy, Moore made the pass. It went off of Q's leg. That time, good play by Johnny Moore. Jordan was going up for the shot, and he was able to catch it out of his hand. A minute and one to go. Bulls still 61 seconds. Bulls still by three. They got a foul to take. Remember that, Bill.
Yeah, that's right. They have one left.
Not in the action of shooting. All right, they're going to open it up here. Jake O'Donnell says, let's open it up a little bit.
Cotton Fitzsimmons went to the half-court line to check something.
He chased him back. He wants a full reset of the clock. He gets 22 seconds on it.
Spurs have been turning it over. Bulls just added to their total with that most recent turnover by Jordan.
What?
Mitchell, they just get it in and beat the five-second count. Gilmore for the hook. He missed it. Fight for the rebound. Banks missed on the shot. The rebound comes out to Johnson, and he's fouled.
No jump?
No.
Is it a jump?
They can roll a jump ball, I think.
Yeah, they did. Jump ball, just two guys trying to earn a living out there. Watch it. They both come down. Steve's got it. Now he swings it around. Banks strong, hangs on, and it's a jump ball. Big jump ball.
3-inch height advantage to the Bulls on the jump. Banks is 6'7". Johnson is 6'10 and a quarter. Banks is a good jumper. Actually make Banks 6'8 for whatever it's worth. But Johnson has a clear height advantage. Up in the air. Banks won the tip, but it went to Jordan. Jordan driving. Basket! Michael Jordan with 43, and the Bulls have a 5-point lead. Timeout San Antonio. They take one of their two remaining.
What a big job by Steve Johnson again. He got the tip. Michael Jordan stayed back. He stayed back to give him a little presence in the backcourt. The tap came to Michael Jordan. He went down. He saw Johnny Moore. Banks trying to catch up. Takes it in. One hand protects it. And just out of the way goes Johnny Moore. And up off the glass and floating through for his 43rd points. Bulls 5-point lead. 49 seconds. Look at the reaction. They love it here. This kid has come to lead him. I'll tell you, he has done such a
jumping ovation. Everybody's standing. Everybody is standing now. It's the Bulls with a 5-point lead.
And waiting in the wings, the end of this week, the Boston Celtics, the champions, and the Philadelphia 76ers.
Spurs will put it in play. 49 seconds left. If the Bulls hold defensively here, they're in great shape. They're not guarding the inbound pass. Banks, low feed to Gilmore. He's going up for it. Jordan wanted to block his shot. It was a foul in there.
This is what we said. They had to take the foul quickly, and they allowed Gilmore to catch it, pivot, go up, slam it home, and grab the... They gave him a three-point situation here. A very, very poor play by the Bulls.
Well, there you go. They got it in there deep, and there was nobody there. And then Jordan dropped back, tried to swat the ball away, and he went right over the top of Gilmore. Now, Gervin comes out for a second.
They're bringing Roberts in now.
They're trying to put some extra pressure on.
Not Fred Rods Robertson. That's the rookie now.
Yeah, 21, Andre Robertson.
Elvin Robertson on the Olympic team.
Oh, and Gilmore rolled up a big free throw right there. He is 19. Three-point play, both by two, 45 seconds left. Here's the pressure. Jordan brings it across, dribbling. Hands it to Daly. Quentin Daly, pressure's on him. Moore tried for the steal. Daly in the paint, he'll go for it. He got it! He got it! Quentin Daly with 18 points. And the Bulls again with a 4-point lead. 28 seconds left. San Antonio needs a basket in a hurry. Mitchell driving. No, and the board. Whistle. Foul.
I think Banks is going to go to the line, though. Orlando Wilbur's got the rebound. It's on him. He gave a little shove. Shot missed outside. You know, I think Mitchell wanted to be out at the three-point area when he took that, but he was inside it for two. He missed the shot, Orlando Woolridge, on the rebound. Now let's watch some playing on the free throw line for some missed shots. Banks will have two.
Well, Gervin is not in the lineup right now, or did he just check back in? No, he's not in.
Gotta save him. All right, now he made this one. They've got to foul the Bulls. The Bulls can't hold it for 21 seconds. They can run this out.
Yeah, they can conceivably hold it the rest of the way. The shot clock has been turned off. Banks, he missed! Gilmore lost the rebound out of bounds. The Bulls have it! The Bulls have it!
Get the ball in quick. Never mind the timeout. Get it in quick. Oh, they're going to take the timeout. Oh, they had the Spurs backpedaling and not really in position. You wanted to get the ball in now. They're going to talk it over with Scottie Robertson. I know Kevin wants this game severely.
Oh, okay. He
wants to make sure that we get a
man at the foul line. And let's see, Caldwell Jones now coming out. So my guess is you try to foul Steve Johnson. If you're looking from San Antonio's perspective, you're going to go after Steve Johnson or perhaps Woolridge here. The Bulls.
I think they've got a 20-second timeout, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, Bulls have a 20 left. And Orlando Woolridge will put it in bounds right in front of our broadcast position here at center court. Oh, we'll take the ball. Bulls by three, 19 seconds remaining. There's the clock inserted in your screen. Woolridge, 20 seconds. There's the timeout.
20-second timeout.
Bulls take a 20. It looked like Quentin Daly had broken loose there for a moment right in front of us, but Orlando did not pass him the ball.
I'll tell you something. There goes the 20-second timeout. They're going to go back. I don't know what it can change now. Maybe they wanted to see where they lined up. I would think that you'd want to come back with that picket line again, Bill. Remember that?
They were
successful with that up in Detroit.
Yeah, the Congo line, the stack.
Yeah, they put four right across about 5 or 10 feet in from this center line.
That's almost impossible to defend, Red. There's John Kovler.
Rod Thorne, Jonathan Kovler sitting there.
And
Rod can't watch it. He is nervous Nelly, I'll tell you that.
I'll tell you, he'd be a lot more nervous than we were
one
tied.
One more bite in his nails, he'll be hitting his watch.
There we go. It's a line. It's a picket line.
All right, the Bulls get it inbounds to Jordan. Trying for a steal. Robertson, and he drew the foul. Robertson gets his first.
Now you need George Gervin back in. Well, here he comes now. Okay, yeah. Artis comes back in. They took him out.
They're platooning now. They're offensive and defensive units.
That's right. They took Mitchell, Artis Gilmore out, and Gervin in. They needed some defensive, very quick players. Scotty doesn't have any. I mean, Scotty, I want to call him. He's there on the bench with
him. Yeah, yeah.
But Cotton Fitzsimmons, does he have it? I think he's got a timeout left. I think he's got one left.
Yes, he does. According to my chart, he has one left. Jordan at the line. Boy, you like this guy when the pressure's on. He just doesn't miss. 44 points for Jordan. I believe that is the top performance in the league this year. If it isn't, it's right near it. Jordan, 45.
Doesn't miss when it's time.
45 points. I believe that is the best performance in the league this year by an NBA player. Moore looking. Kicks it to Mitchell. He's going to take a three-pointer. Long one. He hit it. Mike Mitchell fires in a home run. Is 23. 6 seconds left. The Bulls lead it by two. In the backcourt, Jordan to Caldwell Jones. 1 second. Foul. The horn sounds. The foul came in advance of the horn.
They're going to give 1 second.
This game is not over.
1 second. And
1 second on the clock.
This game is not over.
Well, you know what you can do very easily? End it, don't you? He's going to have two free throws here. He'll shoot the first one and miss the second one. As soon as somebody touches it, bazoom, it's over, and you're 9,000 feet from the other basket.
Yeah,
big three-pointer by Mitchell.
So we'll see who goes to the line here after the foul was committed.
Well, it's going
to
be Caldwell Jones.
Yeah, that's right.
Caldwell Jones steps to the line. I would say give it a shot, make your first one, and I don't care what you do, but just at least hit the rim.
Yeah.
If he's got a... If he's going to miss it, he's got to hit the rim.
So Caldwell Jones has a chance to ice this game away. The Bulls, if they win, will be 7-2 on the year.
Well, we talked about Caldwell Jones, a good free throw shooter, getting up there, and he has not shot for a long, long time. Everybody on their feet, including the Spurs and the Bulls.
Over right there.
Academics.
That's it. Good night.
All right, now he can miss it if he wants to, and I will forgive him for missing a free throw tonight.
He drills this one, then I would expect the Spurs will take a timeout here. He missed it. That's
it's
it.
Over.
Game's over. That is it. The Bulls came off of the rebound. Didn't matter. The Bulls have won the ball game. By golly, they've defeated the San Antonio Spurs in a magnificent comeback effort by a final score of 120-117.